Hi there, how are you? I hope you're doing great. Today I'm going to review this book and I have to say that it's an amazing edition. You can find this one in hardcover and in paperback. You can see this is the paperback, but it's amazing. It has this kind of rugged cover and the edition, it's beautiful. It's full of color and full of illustrations. And when you finish the each story, you have like a double-sided illustration, and I'm going to tell you why I think that it's like two tales in one. As you can see, it's The Language of Thorns, it's by Leigh Bardugo, and this book is a compilation of stories, and I have to say that I have been very gratefully surprised by all of them, because each ending, each learning that you take from them, it's not exactly what you expected when you began reading. I mean, they are not sweet stories, they are very harsh stories, they're very strong stories, and they are dark and twisted, and they are amazing, and they deliver something you were never expecting and something you were never seen coming. And this is amazing because I was surprised by all of them, and yeah, I just love this book, and I have to say, I show you first that there is this little illustrations in the margins, as you can see when you began, there is some kind of drawings, and then they began to grow and cover more and more space in the pages. As you can see, there is like all of this now and all of this, and in the way that you began reading this story, it's the drawings are just surrounding the story, but in a way they are telling their own story too. They're following the lines that are written, but it's like they are drawing the story, and yeah, they began to complete themselves, and Lily, when you arrive to the double-sided drawing, you see that the drawing has a very strong connection to the story. You have to read the stories and see the drawings, because it's a perfect combination of the two of them, and I have loved this book so much because of that, because the stories that Leigh Bardugo tells are amazing and the drawings are amazing, but what I love most about this book is that you can see that both things complement each other. Maybe in this first story it's not so clear, as later on we can begin seeing another kind of drawings that also accompany the text, and I love how these drawings make this like surroundings, and they tell the same story with drawings. It's amazing. Yeah, I'm repeating myself, I know, but I was so surprised by how beautiful this book is, and how amazing the stories and the drawings are. It's amazing. If you love Leigh Bardugo, you are going to find that these stories, some of them make you think about things that happened in the books. I think that I've seen the Darkling in here, maybe, I don't know. And there is things like how the tunnels on the Ravka were made. I think this here, and one of the stories tells you that. And it's amazing because those are stories that like, they are sort of dark retellings. We have one that makes you think about Hansel and Gretel. You know, these two kids that went to the woods and found a witch that just fed them until she could cook them. We are going to find something similar to here, and we are going to find something like The Little Mermaid, and we are going to find like these things with a very dark twist, and in a way that you learn a lesson from each story, and you keep wondering about what happened there, like, oh my god. I mean, Leigh Bardugo for me is amazing. I have never read her before, and it's like I'm devouring all her books now, and I have to say that I'm surprised that she has that kind of strength, because it's not that you read her stories and you like them, but it's also the fact that when you close the book, these stories stay with you, and you begin thinking about what you have read, and I think that she has this powerful way of telling you something and of honing it home and making it stay with you. And that's amazing for me, because sometimes that you read a book and you enjoy it a lot, but then you close the book and that's it, it's over. But with her, I have found that her stories, her books stay with you long before you have read them. So I will recommend her a lot. In this book you can see there is like all these stories one, two, three, four, five, six stories and author's notes and acknowledgements. And I have to say that I have loved all of the stories. There's only one that for me was like a little bit weird, but I think that's the idea of that story. And I have to say that usually I'm not a person that likes short stories books. I prefer to have a book, you know, a normal, regular one. I don't know how to say that. But this one, I just loved and cherished because it's amazing. It's beautiful. It's thoughtful. It's dark. It has lots of things that are amazing. And as I say, 1,000 times plus one now, I love how the little art in the stories just are telling the same story. And if you pay close attention, you will see things appearing and disappearing. And those are things that have something to tell and that are important. And I love this book. Yeah, read it. Yeah, go read, because it's amazing. If you like Leigh Bardugo, you are going to love this one for sure. And if you haven't read anything, maybe this is a good way to see what she writes about, what kind of writing she has, and you're going to love it because it's an amazing book of short stories. All 6 of them are amazing, and yeah, that's it. Thank you for watching. Bye.